I had David Carr on last hour. He earned a phone call from me. That's for darn sure. When he predicted the Jets would make the playoffs, and then name checked me on last night's NFL Total Access. That was an easy.
There you go.
That was an easy booking to ask David to come on. And he had the time to also talk about his brother, and he mentioned that Davante Adams attempted to get to the Raiders a couple years ago. Before, like, this was not just a long time dream that he decided to take his shot on right now, that he tried it before. Had you heard the same thing, anything on that front, Ian?
I hadn't heard specifically that he had tried before. I mean, but I did know that when people talk about the Packers situation, they say, you know, what went wrong? Why couldn't the Packers pay him? You know, what'd the Packers do to upset him? It wasn't really like that. The Packers tried to pay him. They actually offered him more than the Raiders are going to pay him over the first 3 years of the deal. This was a player who wanted to be in Las Vegas. He wanted to be with one of his good friends, Derek Carr. It was a long-standing relationship. And you know, Davante Adams' relationship with Aaron Rodgers on field is one of the best I can remember and I've ever seen in the last decade. Like, it is amazing. Off the field, it's professional, but not much more. So when, you know, if you're Davante Adams and you say, well, you know, I'd like to sign for 5 years, and you're not sure for the last year or so how long the quarterback's going to be there, if he's going to be there, is it going to be 1 year, is it going to be 2 years, is it going to be 3 years? Like, but if it's the Raiders, like, you know that quarterback's not going anywhere. The Raiders were more appealing to him. So, you know, what David said doesn't surprise me. Because this has been a long-standing thing for Davante Adams.
So outside of the organized team activities, what else is the story of this month or leading into training camp? Is it Gronk? What's his status and thoughts? And, you know, or if you got an answer on that, you know, lead yourself into what you think we're not talking about going into the OTA season here, Ian.
I mean, Gronk is interesting. You know, the indications I've got is that he's going to play. I know, like, he came out and said it, and then his agent kind of walked it back, and then he walked it back again, and I don't know. I mean, for Tom Brady to come back, and then if Gronk decides not to, like, that would be a surprise. I don't know when that's going to be, but I would imagine at some point before training camp we will get some Gronk news, and then it'll probably be good news. I would say, you know, the Aaron Donald story is interesting to me. You know, he has come out and said, you know, basically gave credence to the why retirement is attractive, he might retire talk. The Rams have said talks are trending in the right direction. You know, when and if that gets wrapped up is obviously going to be a major deal. You know, other than that, I think it's a lot of waiting. It's waiting for Garoppolo. When does something happen with him, or does he just show up to training camp and just take part in practice? What about Baker? You know, it's Deshaun Watson. I mean, this time of year is generally about this, but more than I can ever remember, we are all waiting for multiple shoes to drop before we figure out how multiple other parties are going to pursue.
So then let's just hit a couple of them right here. Donald, right? He says it's not about the money, but he also needs to make sure the business is right for him and his family, and he's at peace otherwise. I mean, that is. Code for they're talking about redoing his deal, right? Like, that conversation is happening.
Right.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. It is happening, but I don't get the sense he's saying, oh, I may retire just for contract leverage. I think he actually is considering retiring. And it makes sense because he's 30. He's one of the best to ever do it. He's made $100 million, and he's won a Super Bowl. So, like, if you told me that Aaron Donald is good to go, doesn't need to play anymore, I would say that's too bad because he's awesome, but I could see that, right? Now, obviously, for the Rams, there's a number where he would say, well, I can't turn this down. And we'll see if they get there. That's kind of where this all stands, I believe.
Don't they have to pay Kupp, too? Isn't that being discussed as well?
I mean, Cooper Kupp would, I'm sure, like a contract extension. I believe that, I believe that's on the radar. And, you know, I mean, you know, every receiver has gotten paid. He certainly is productive, if not more productive than any of them. So, yes, I would think that is sort of on the radar as well for the Rams.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.